In other words, whatever that we can see, we can touch, we are enjoying, will pass away. But the work of God will never. Your car will pass away. Your beautiful cloth will pass away. Houses will perish. Human beings, kings, queens, chiefs, presidents, prime ministers, they will all pass away. We tend to meet a lot of people on this earth. Some were president, and now they are no more again. We cannot even see them, we cannot even remember them. But the Bible says only the word of God is eternal. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, tell somebody beside you that the word will never pass away. That is why all that you need in life, is the word of God. When you read Isaiah chapter 40 verse 8, the Bible says the grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of God stands forever. The word of God stands forever. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of God stands forever. When you read Hebrew chapter 1 Peter chapter 1 verses 23, here's what I want us to know about the power in the word of God. 1 Peter chapter 1 verses 23. Stand there for me. Here the Bible is saying, we have been born by the word of God. So I was meeting, I said, God, now we have not been born again by our parents or by anybody again, and now we have been born by the word. So you have been born by the word of God. And here, look at the adjective that the Bible used to, you know, describe the word. The incorruptible. The incorruptible nature of the word of God. The incorruptible, something that cannot perish, something that cannot be destroyed. That is how the word was, you know, described. The incorruptible nature of the word of God, which lives and what abides forever and ever. So in other words, when you have this word inside you, I've not got the when you have this word inside you, if the word of God is incorruptible, if the word of God is indestructible, if there is nothing that you can do to the word of God, and this word resides within you, then it means you have eternal life. Oh, hallelujah. You have everlasting life when you have the word inside you. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, amen. You cannot be destroyed because of the word of God in you. Oh, amen. Oh, say to yourself, I can't be destroyed because the word of God is in me. Oh, amen. The word of God. See, you have been born by the incorruptible nature of the word of God. So no wonder the Bible said, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. So you have the word of God in you. And the Bible said there is creative power in the word of God. And of course, let there be light, and darkness vanished. Darkness could not resist that light. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. Oh, may the Lord bless you. Your amen is very low. Shout amen. Ah, shout amen. Oh, amen. Put your hands together for the name of the Lord. There is this thing I want you to know. Number 4. The word has been lifted above his name. The word of God has been lifted above even the name
the name of Jesus was what? Also does. And the Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. You know it. When you read Philippians, it said, he has therefore lifted his name above all other names. But at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee must bow. And every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And here the Bible is saying in the book of Psalm 138 verse 2. Psalm 138 verse 2. Let's read. Do you understand what I'm trying to communicate to you? Psalm 138 verse 2.
Opens
the window of heavens for our prayers answer to our prayers. It is the word of God that gives an answer to our prayers. John chapter 15, verse 7. John 15, verse 7. I told today we are going to read a lot. Amen. John chapter 15, verse 7.
If you abide in me,
and my words abide in you,
you shall ask whatever you desire,
and it shall be given unto you.
So your prayer can only be answered when you have the word of God in you.
So without the word, you can shout and shout and shout and you receive nothing.
Hallelujah. I don't want to go very deep into what I was saying. Let me say The word brings healing. The word of God brings healing. Bible says there was this man who was a soldier. And in the word, in New Testament, that is the Jewish custom, when somebody is a soldier and the person has got 100 people under him, they describe him as a centurion. Centurion. So this man was a soldier, and one of his servants was seriously ill. So Jesus, this man comforted Jesus, that my servant is ill, and I want you to come and pray for him. And Jesus said, you go, I'll come to your house and pray. He said, no, Jesus, I don't need you under my roof. All that I need is the word. All that I need is what? The word. Not just to speak the word. And I know my servant will be well. Not just to speak. I don't need you. I don't need your presence. I need your word. I need your word. But this man knows what the word can do in his life. I need the word. I don't need you. Matthew chapter 8, verses 8. Amen. Let me give you the 7th point. The word can move you from nothing to abundance. The word of God can move you from nothing to abundance. So in this life, it's only the word of God that can promote you. The word of God can lift you from the bottom to the top.
Amen.
So the Bible says promotion comes neither from the north, not from the west, not from the east or south, but from where? From God. That is the word of God. So it is only the word of God that can promote you. It's not about, I'm not saying don't be hard working person. What I'm saying is that if you want promotion, then prioritize the word of God first in your life. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So the word can move you from nothing to abundance. Peter was a professional fisherman. Bible says he worked for the whole day and night and he catch nothing. And he met Jesus. And Jesus said, launch out onto the deep. And Peter said something. Jesus, I have worked all this night and all this day and I have never, you know, even kept a catch. And Jesus said, I said, launch out onto the deep. And Peter was looking at Jesus and he said, because of your word, because of your word, I will do it. And Bible says, after he did it, he had a lot of what? Flesh. The word of God can move you from nothing to abundance. From few to many, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray this morning that may the word of God give you all that you need in life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Shout amen.
Amen.
It doesn't matter how long you have been following that thing, the word of God can give it unto you within a twinkle of an eye. Oh, receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The word of God can come. Every storm of life. The word of God can calm every storm of life. The Bible said Jesus was in the boat with his disciples. And there was this great storm that arise. The Bible said, and the disciples of Jesus were shaking. They didn't know what to do. And the Bible said Jesus was at the back sleeping. The Bible said they called Jesus. Now don't you know that we are perishing? And Jesus said something. Peace. When I speak the word of God into your life, every storm, every problem, every challenge that you're going through, that peace be still. Say that to me, peace be still. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Bible says, the storm ceased. And the disciples said, what manner of man is this? The wind obeys you. All that you need is the word of God.
Amen.
All that you need is the word of God.
Amen.
When you have the word of God, you have God himself. 1, Jesus said something that most assuredly I say unto you, if anyone keeps my word, he shall never see death.
Amen.
Most assuredly, this is the only thing that Jesus can even say to his disciples, that is the only truth that I can tell you, that if you keep my word, you shall never see death. So in other words, when you have the word of God in you, disease cannot kill you. Hypertension cannot kill you. No disease can affect you. Hallelujah. So it's most assured. Mark chapter 8, verse 51. If anyone had his words in me, he would never see death. Hallelujah.
Your life, not a
morning, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. And open the eyes of your understanding, that you will know these mysteries that I'm sharing with you. And you will know the efficacy and potency of God's word. And you will know that it's only the word of God that can help you in life. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord give unto you whatever you need according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Somebody shout a big amen. And put your hands together for the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Wow. That was a powerful message. God bless you, Elder Patrick. God bless you. Our time is almost up, but we still have to receive our tithe and our offering. So please, let us...